Can we do this?
No peace! No peace! No peace!
Don't shoot!
Don't shoot! Don't shoot! Don't shoot!
No peace!
No justice!
No peace!
You want to talk to the KPD?
Hey,
for that drum beat.
Yeah, can you bring your chief outside? Send him a shirt.
Yeah.
Hey,
send a white shirt out.
Hey,
come
on,
please.
Each
one.
Come on,
please. We're over here, bro. Don't start that. Hey, I'm just putting it in here.
Hey, listen. No justice,
no peace.
No justice,
no peace.
No justice,
no peace.
No justice,
no peace.
No,
bro, we ain't
on that MLK
shit.
Same shit, that shit over with.
I'm saying, peaceful people, what you here for? This peaceful rally, bro.
Yeah, peace.
No justice, no peace.
All right, look.
You here for peace, nobody's peace, bro.
Hey, so this is still a peaceful protest.
You here for the peace?
This is a peaceful protest. This isn't about negative nothing. Nobody said that, so I don't know why that's being said.
No justice, no peace.
Hey, everybody. If we're gonna move and have one voice, it can't be separated.
So let's let the one voice.
You're still arguing. You're divided.
So that's when you say no peace, no power. That's what they want.
Listen, all I'm saying is, y'all, of course it's peaceful, but at the same time, those are the cops. They gotta hear this. What is we doing here? They gotta hear it. If they said only one cop about here and he in the car, he's not here. They ain't watching our Facebook. They gotta hear this, man. They don't want us killing us. Shit, come on, man. Of course we gotta stick together too. But at the same time, those are the people that need to be hearing this right now.
Yes.
These same forces ain't
with them, not ourselves.
Yeah.
racism, social, as far as education as well. We have too many issues in this city to come against one another.
Yes.
We have to come together. This is a unity march. This is a unity protest. Yes. We are not here in divisiveness. If you are here in divisiveness, please go elsewhere. Exactly. We're here together as brothers and sisters. We're representative of all lives.
Yes.
Yes. So I need you to come together. I need you to listen. I need your voice to speak loud to these people, okay? If you want to see racism, decease, and desist, your voices need to be heard today. This is a peaceful protest on today. We need blue lives as well. We need them to change. We need them to hear us on today. Okay? I don't like to be followed. I don't like when I turn a corner, they turn a corner. I don't like my black brother being shot. I don't like my black brother with a knee on his neck. I know you don't either, and I know you're here for change. So in order to be part of change, you have to be the change. Be the change on today. Okay? We need to show love. We need to show peace.
Compassion.
What they're doing in the other cities, I commend them for marching. I commend them for protesting. But I don't commend the violence. We have to show them that we can peacefully do this. We are asking for change in this city from the police chiefs on down. We need change in this city.
Yes.
The mass incarceration rate is very high in Wisconsin. We are the state with the most people incarcerated. Today is the day. Today is the day that we evoke change in this city. Today is the day that our children have education equality. Today is the day that we change mass incarceration and recidivism rates in this town. Today is the day that we change poverty in this town. Today is the day. So if you're a part of change, I need you to speak change today.
Yes.
Amen? I need you to speak change. So I need you to march. I need you to speak. And we're here, and they're going to hear us loud and clear today. That we want change. We're not coming here to burn down no city. We have not come here to loot. We have not come here to evoke violence. We come in peace, but we expect change. We want oversight of this police department. We want oversight. And that is what we come here as citizens for, oversight today. So I encourage and I implore the chief of police to give us oversight. We need a citizens representative group for oversight of this police department, every police department around this nation.
Woo!
So I am asking the chief of police to give us oversight for any violation, any racial profiling in this city. I am a veteran. I refuse to be treated like a second-class citizen in this city that I change. We're not here to fight one against one another. We don't need them in our business today. We need them to listen. We don't need handcuffs today.
Yes.
I refuse to come bail one of you out today. Please. I refuse to see you on the ground like George Floyd today. Please. Get along. Unite for one cause, one purpose. That purpose is George Floyd today. So if you came out here today, you're here for George Floyd. Because he's not here today. He's not here to speak for himself. Trayvon Martin is not here today. He's not here to speak for himself. Tamar Rice is not here today. You are Tamar Rice. You are Trayvon Martin. You are Philando Castro. You are George Floyd. You are each and every one of us, black and white, blue and brown. All lives matter today. So I need you to march with me. I don't need you to march against one another. It is time out today. Yeah. It is time out today. All lives matter today.
All lives matter today.
No justice, no peace.
No justice, no peace.
All right, so we get it. All lives matter. We get Black Lives Matter. Right? So let's talk about Nakia Shannon's son. Let's talk about Michael Bell. You marching for people around the world, but your own people here are getting murdered. Your own people here needed your help and your voice. We have to have accountability. I'm a part of the problem.
if this man do me wrong, I'm gonna defend myself. You call him an op, and then you go shoot. But yet when the police shoot, you say, oh, it's just the police. When are we gonna hold accountability to us too? We have to fix us and then fix them. While we fix us, we get our education, our economical standpoint, and then we hold accountability to all. We cannot just sit and have a voice when it's somebody else. We have to have a voice when a little boy gets shot, or a little girl gets shot, or a grown man gets shot. Not when they just get locked up. No. You gotta actually hold accountability. If you see the back of my shirt, it ain't just the cops or the Ku Klux Klan, it's us killing us too. When are you gonna speak up for that? Because there's a lot of mothers and a lot of fathers burying children daily. When you go march, no justice, no peace. All lives, no. Our children's lives matter, but black lives matter now, period. And they will always matter. I'm not speaking on Italian lives and nobody else's lives because I'm African. I'm speaking on African lives because African lives have been taken and we've been downgraded. You are systematically already imprisoned in your mind, and you need to realize you've already been planted that. You hating yourself, and you don't need to hate yourself. We need umoja, unity and togetherness. But it starts with education. It starts with loving yourself first. Please love yourself. Please educate your children. Please educate and hold down your families. Stop walking away so easily. Fight for something. Stand for everything. But realize, you can't call for war each time. What's the end goal? What are you trying to achieve? The youngest war was 4 years. Are you ready to bury people for 4 years? Do you have the resources? Do you have any of that? Do you have an end goal? What's the end goal? You want justice? The cops locked up. You want justice? All right.
All of them locked up.
Get the same, no. All of them ain't locked up. Because the Asian dude ain't locked up. But I need, hold on. Pardon me. The thing is, we want equal people in our police department. They got rid of Officer West and they hired one other African-American officer. But where is the rest from your neighborhoods? You got what? How many African-American aldermen? Aldermen? You got one. But your votes count on that. They always trafficking and they doing routes uptown and up by Model Market. Go by Anderson Park where the cocaine is. You don't see no cops riding around. Go to Christmas Lane where the crack is. You don't see them riding around. You want equality, you gotta police the police. You have to have, like she said, a representative so we actually can have a voice. Because one voice on the alderman side ain't gonna work. And the thing is, no, it's not gonna change and it's not gonna get better because we're not educating each other. And you don't have accountability of yourself. And until we actually have accountability of one another, we ain't nothing gonna change. Nothing changed from the civil rights. Nothing changed because if you wanna be a hero, you become a martyr. And then everybody stops. True or false?
True.
Okay, so who's ready to be the martyr? Exactly. Then start with education, accountability, responsibility, and make them answer for their actions. And you answer for your actions. All I'm trying to say is, knowledge talk, wisdom listens. Thank you for listening.
No justice, no peace, man. We listen. If I would have got caught with some, say I would have been on a drug case, he would have been with me. I would have been party to a crime.
That's right.
What my shirt say? Listen, we is now standing as one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. It's not justice for all. It's only. It's not justice for all.
Justice for some.
Man, come on, man. This shit.
Come on,
this
keep
is,
going. Keep going.
All this politics shit is over with.
Come on, man.
You feel me?
Yes.
Man, this shit. Man, yes. Y'all understand?
This
we
shit
the one
that
hurt. Our children's the one that hurt. Come on, man. We the one that's walking up on any shit. We can pull it over. We living in your polite. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. they still treat us as veterans. Come on, bro. We looking for real justice right here.
Preach, bro. Preach. Preach
for real justice here.
Preach. Preach, bro. Preach.
Racism is real. We are all out here protesting today. But the most important thing that we have to do is we have to go to the polls. It is a moot point if we stay and we protest, but we don't go to the polls in November. I need each and every one of you to be at the polls. If not, you need to do your absentee ballot. We need to change from the White House on down. It starts at the White House. So you want change, that's where it starts. Okay? That's what it's all about. The right to vote, we were given the right to vote because a man marched and because thousands marched. We were given some liberty because of the march, but they went to the polls when they were given the ability to vote. The vote counts. Make your politicians accountable. Hold them accountable. Send those emails. Send those letters. Make those calls. Action speaks louder than Facebook. Okay? Action speaks pray, protest, poll. That's the best piece of wisdom I can give each and every one of you. No justice, no peace.
Okay, so I am a black woman who's been growing up in Kenosha, Wisconsin my whole entire life. And I just want to say, that Kenosha, Wisconsin, we all know that we have to watch our backs, and I don't even commit crimes. I never committed a crime, and I still have to watch my back. When I drive down the street, when my kids is outside, it's too much of us in a group. We having a family event. It's got to be, the police got to drive by. So we already know how many people that went to jail and got beat up in jail, in this jail right behind me. How many of y'all people been locked up for little of nothing? How many times we got to watch people who did so much more raping people get out? And but we get treated like we just killed somebody and we didn't even do nothing close to it. I'm tired. Everybody is tired. This is why we're here. We're all tired. We're all tired of seeing people walk away who killed people on the news, all the evidence, everything there. We're so tired. But what I really, really, really need for everybody to do is to be on the same accord, to have the same voice. So I feel like right now we can move mountains if we have the one voice. One voice. No peace, no justice. We stand all together for once. And I have not really seen this in Kenosha. And I will be honest, I have not really seen all of us come together. And I give my hands to all the white people who is here today. I give my hands to all the young people who are not scared because they try to put fear in us. They try to put fear in us. And they have succeeded. There's so many people, every time I was on Facebook, all I kept seeing was, be careful, be careful where you walk, be careful what you say, be careful because they know, just like they know, what goes on out here. So all I'm saying is, let's just stand on one, let's stand together, let's not fight each other, we got all, whatever for time for that. This is here for one cause, so if we want to march, let's be all on one voice. If anybody got something to say, I feel like have your voice. This is your time, this is your city, these are your people, because it's not just black people, it's white people, it's Mexican people, it's whoever's with us that's going to go down regardless, no matter what. So it's stand for what you believe in. I promise I will never fall or bend my knee to nothing that is injustice, period. So.
We are all in this together. And so we want to hear from our other brothers and sisters.
Thank you so much, black brothers and sisters, white brothers and sisters, everyone who's here to make a systemic change. It's been going on too long. I'm originally from DC, I'm a veteran too, through the Marine Corps, and then afterwards I found myself in Kenosha. I learned about what segregation actually looks like. I learned about redlining. Where I'm from, I was in a pretty privileged location. I didn't realize what the Midwest and the South looks like. And now, I see young people united. I've been a teacher in Racine and in Milwaukee, and I've gone to college at Parkside. I see young people and I see a lot of hope. It gives me so much hope for the future, because up until this point, we haven't had a general movement like this nationwide. I think we broke a record this weekend nationwide. And this is certainly the first time I've seen something like this in Kenosha. So thank you so much. Black Lives Matter. We care about what's happening to our black brothers and sisters, the unequal treatment in the justice system, yeah, and in this whole system designed to put them down and keep them down. Thank you so much.
I do want to give it up for one person. It all it takes is one person to invoke change. One person decided to make a change, and one person decided to do that in Kenosha, and I'm very proud of her. She happens to be here. So I give it up for Kaya. Kaya!
That they burnt down. Before we started murdering each other, when we actually was educating our children about reading, writing, math, everything else, we were going that route. And then with the Black Panther Party, when they put sleeper cells in to murder us and to get Brother Huey and everybody locked up. You aren't violent people. We are loving, nurturing, caring people. We innovate. We set trends. We are powerful. We have love in our heart, but we will defend.
We will.
And right now, I'm asking you to think before you try to defend something that isn't yours. Okay? We are African. The people that's American aren't from here. They're Native Americans. This is their land. So how are you an African American? You know, you're an African. So African lives matter. It's about education. You gotta understand what you think you understand.
Explain to me about what you mean by defending something that's not yours.
This is, I'm a veteran. I'm gonna tell you the truth. This land.
Yeah, I wanna know what you mean.
Is this yours? Do you own your land? Did you get reparations yet?
No.
They don't own the land because it ain't their country.
Who country is it?
It's the Native Americans.
Who's the Native Americans?
The Indians. The Africans came here in the trade.
The Moors.
Alright, no justice, no peace. We go back to the plot of the whole thing. What I'm trying to say is it's about education. It's about knowledge. It is about being loving the way you truly are. Set your heart on loving and educating your children. Not only on self-defense, weapons, everything. Why is the store sold out? Why is it okay to shoot in the country? They're training up. And I think you need to train up and get educated too. No man on growing your own fruits, growing your own gardens, getting your resources right. Get your resources. You need your resources. Do you know how to grow carrots, potatoes? Have you been growing it? Remember your grandma used to grow it all in the backyard, right? Your tomatoes, your green tomatoes. If your lives matter, we got to start empowering ourselves. But we gonna hold them accountable as well. I'm not getting off that topic. We just waiting until he come outside. But before we sit back and put our knee in his chest, we need to let him know. We educated about our history ourselves, and we won't let nobody take it from us. Exactly.
Educate our children.
That's what we talk about. Educating our children and re-educating ourselves to loving ourselves, not harming each other, but defending our homes because it's our right. Even though the Constitution wasn't meant for us and we weren't even counted as a full person, we are more than a full person. You are a young God. And I need you to know that. If you're built in this image, then you need to be called by your name. You are godly. God is in each and every one of you. Okay? So please, I want you to be safe while you out here. Don't fight amongst each other. It is okay to disagree and have an equal conversation, but you not need to be violent toward each other, because I would be part of the problem if I told you I don't respect your opinion.
An opinion is opinion, but you can come to a mutual understanding. That's called a conversation, right?
Yes, sir.
A discussion, right? That's what needs to be had. And if you cannot agree to disagree, then who are you? Knowledge talks, wisdom listens. We all die. The goal is not to live forever, but to create something that will. And we are going to create our heritage and our lineage so it leaves that legacy of no more weakness. Okay?
Hey man, they ain't coming out, man. They just right there standing there. We can go.
Let's go in.
No. Let's do it. I can't offer anything.
No justice, no peace.